Hey everybody, welcome in. My name is Ernest and I'm going to teach you how to cook. Today I'm taking the idea of meatballs and going in a whole different direction. Oh yeah, we're making sweet chili meatballs. These are going to be a hit at any party. All you got to do is make them and watch them disappear. Forget about those barbecued wieners. We're going with the meatballs today. And this is Eating in Bed. You know, living in New York, you find a lot of people making a whole lot of meatballs. Sometimes they're really good, sometimes they're really not. Okay. It's always Italian too. It's basil, oregano, garlic, onion. It gets kind of boring after a while. I mean, if I go to an Italian restaurant, I want Italian food, but if I go someplace else, change it up a little bit. And that's what I'm doing today. I'm making turkey meatballs, actually, but you can use ground beef with this. The meatloaf mix that we've talked about before, like in the meatloaf show and other things, that's really good to use as well. But today I'm just using some ground turkey. It's really easy. There's a couple of ingredients that might make you raise your eyebrow just a little bit, but stick with me on this. It's really good, and these are really great at a party, and I'll tell you about that as we go along. But let's get started. I've got some stuff laid out here, and I'm gonna start with 2 pounds of ground turkey. This is 94% lean. I wanted a good lean turkey, but like I said, you can use ground beef on this if you want to. Not a big deal. Just trying to make something a little bit healthier, and just break this up a little bit with your hands. And actually, you need to preheat your oven to 350 degrees. These are gonna bake just a really short amount of time. But let's get the ingredients in the turkey. So first, we're gonna start off with panko breadcrumbs. Panko breadcrumbs are those wonderful little Japanese breadcrumbs that you can get in the store. If you don't have panko, you can use regular breadcrumbs. Just make sure they're unseasoned, because the seasoned breadcrumbs usually tends to be an Italian seasoning, and we're not doing Italian food today. So I'm using 2/3 of a cup. This is a 1/3 cup. Measurement, so I'm going to do 2 of these. If you didn't want to make this many meatballs as this yields, you can easily just cut the recipe in half. If you're doing this for a big party, simply double the recipe. It works really great that way. Now, 2 extra large eggs, get them right in there. You can beat them beforehand if you want to, but I don't really see a problem with just breaking them right in there. These are close to room temperature. They just tend to blend a little better that way, but if they're cold, that's fine too. Here I have about 1/2 cup of finely chopped cilantro. If you don't like cilantro, and a lot of people don't like that cilantro taste because they get a soapy aftertaste, it just depends on, you know, your taste buds. You can use any kind of a parsley if you wanted to. And green onion. This is actually 6 green onions. I cut almost all the way to the top. I had about this much of the top left, and I actually save these little bits when you're making chicken stock or something. This still has an oniony flavor, even though they're not very edible. Straight out, you can put them in your stock for a nice onion flavor. So this is 6 green onions. I chopped them up pretty well. I'm gonna need about 1 tablespoon of ginger. And ginger comes, it's this little root that looks like this. And you really want to peel it with a spoon. If you just take the spoon and run it down the side of your ginger, the skin comes right off of there. Now we're going to need about 1 tablespoon in this. So I have a microplane. You can find these online anywhere. I think I put it in a link before in a past recipe. And you can just use this to grate right into your bowl. You could chop this and mince it if you wanted to. I don't think you can really, it's really fibrous. So I don't think you can really put it through a garlic press. If you're a big fan of ginger, you can put a little bit more in there, up to 2 tablespoons, usually 1 tablespoon per pound of meat product that we're using here. I also have 2 cloves of garlic. I finally minced them instead of pressing them into this, because I wanted the texture in all of this. So that's 2 good-sized cloves of garlic right in there. And then I'm also gonna add 1 teaspoon of salt. A good little pinch of red pepper flakes. What would a recipe be without some red pepper flakes? Just about 1/8 of a teaspoon. You can use up to 1/4 if you really wanted a little bit more heat to it. And finally, about 1 to 2 teaspoons of apple cider vinegar. I'm going straight in here. This adds a little bit of tartness to it, a little bit of brightness, and a little bit of acidity. And of course, what would chili meatballs be without the chili? This is chili sauce. This is Bennett's chili sauce. You can find this in stores kind of here in the Northeast. This is a 12-ounce container, and we're gonna need a half a cup to put in the meat right here. Oh, look at that. It's got a lot of nice flavors and good stuff in it. Save the other part of this, keep it handy, because you might need it later on, and I'll tell you why in a minute. The smell of that chili sauce is so nice. It's got that ketchup-y smell, but it's a little bit spicy, not a lot. So with a fork, you can use clean hands if you want to. Lightly fluff all of this together. I just don't feel like getting my hands dirty. In fact, let me close this so there's no turkey that pops in there like that. And just blend this together. Now, once all that's pulled together, let's get this into a baking dish. I have an 11 by 14 baking dish. This is a little bigger than the standard 10 by 13 or 10 by 14. This is about maybe 11 by 15, I think. I'm gonna put about a half a teaspoon of oil in the bottom of my baking dish here and then just lightly grease it. Now you wanna make about 1-inch meatballs. I'm going a little bit bigger with this ice cream scoop that I have, but if you needed to go a little smaller, you could on that and just pull out some of the meat. You know, a flat portion just like that. And you can kind of roll it in your hand. Don't compact it too much, but just roll it in your hand. Wonderful little meatball. It should be a scooch smaller than a golf ball. But if you were serving a lot of people with this, you could actually use the smaller ice cream scoop, which is probably about, gosh, what, a teaspoon and a half or something, those little ones? Okay, so I'm just about done putting them in here. Time has passed, the magic of television. Here we go. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I have 15 in here, and I still have probably about another pound of turkey mix right here. So I'm gonna put that in a second bowl before we get this into the oven. I'm gonna get these right in there. They're gonna go about 20 minutes total. At the 10 minute mark, go in with a little spatula, maybe an offset spatula so you don't disturb them too much, and turn them over. You want them to kind of evenly cook and do that little caramelization thing that they do on both sides. So we're gonna put this in there, 10 minutes, turn them over, then go another 10 minutes, 20 minutes total. When these come out of the oven, you really wanna kinda let them set for about another 10 minutes, just so the juices kinda come back together, they kind of solidify a little bit. If they're too hot and you start to mess with them, they're just gonna fall apart on you, and they're gonna be super tender anyway. I'm gonna do the rest of the meatballs. I'm gonna get them in the oven, turn them after 10 minutes, go another 10 minutes, let them cool 10 minutes. I'll see you on the other side of the break. We're gonna try these things. They're gonna be pretty tasty. I'll see you right after this.
Linda's soundtrack's feverish. What she's doing is sick, but nice.
Keep your money. Don't pay me till next year.
It's no money down. No payments till 87 on this terrific Kenwood car stereo. Digital tuning, auto reverse, 4 speakers, $299 installed.
Just take it.
Take this. Yamaha remote control 100-watt concert music system. Only $43 a month.
Keep your cash. Flash. Max sale tape on sale now at Soundtrack. Come on.
Hurry to Soundtrack now before she realizes what she's doing. No money down. No payments till 87 now.
Okay, the meatballs are out of the oven. Oh, the house smells so good. That chili sauce smells so great. Now, here's what I did. Let me show you. At the 10-minute mark, when I turned the meatballs over, I took a little bit more of the chili sauce because we had half a jar of it, and I dabbed it on all of the meatballs so it would kind of caramelize and cook on top. And this, da-da-da-da, is what they look like when they're done. They've been sitting here about 10 minutes, kind of cooling down. And let me show you this. They're really, actually, can I touch this? I can touch this. Move this here. Got a wonderful little serving platter here. And these come right out. If you just let them set a little bit. Mmm, look at that. Aren't those gorgeous? Now listen, these 2 pounds made 27 turkey balls. Can you even believe it? And look what's great about this. A lot of the excess fat that was in the meatballs kind of solidifies in the pan, so when you lift them up, you can kind of pop them right out of that oil, or the, you know, the fat or whatever, and not get any in there. Now, like I said, if you're doing this for a party, it's at this point you're going to take them and put them in your slow cooker. And if you're doing the slow cooker thing, you don't have to dab them with some chili sauce. Because I went, like I said, 10 minutes. When I turned them over, I basted them with a little chili sauce, put them back in for the 10 minutes and let them finish cooking. If you're going in the slow cooker with this, you can skip that whole step. You still need to turn them over, but you don't have to, you don't have to dab them with any chili sauce. You're going to take the remaining chili sauce that you have in your jar and just pour it over the meatballs in your slow cooker, slowly stir them so everything's combined, and then keep it on low. Look at this. I mean, they're just, it makes so much. And remember, these are a little bit bigger. If we were to use that smaller ice cream scoop, we would definitely have even more meatballs here. Now, I am going to try one of these that I got. I have two or three left over that doesn't necessarily fit on the plate, but I'm going to cut right into it. They're nice and firm. Turkey really firms up kind of nicely. They're really nice. Oh, it just smells so good. You smell that cilantro and a little bit of that chili sauce. They've cooled. Oh, they're so tender. They've cooled down so you can bite right into them. Mmm. That green onion, you get a little bit of the ginger, but it's not harsh. It's almost like an aromatic in your nose. That green onion is amazing. Holy smokes. There's a nice rich flavor because of the garlic. Boy, that ginger is really crazy in there. That's wonderful. Mmm. How can you not love that? All right, so give this recipe a try. Give it a thumbs up if you would. Leave a comment below. Do you make these kind of meatballs for parties? I would love to hear about it. So leave a comment, click subscribe so you don't miss anything. There's a lot of meatballs here, but I'm gonna go maybe have a couple more before the roommate comes home. Don't tell anybody. I appreciate you watching. Try these for a party, put them in a slow cooker with some extra sauce and serve them up and let me know what happens. I have a feeling they're gonna disappear pretty quickly and you're gonna be the hit of the party. Thank you for watching and I will see you next time. Bye.